Hello, everyone. So first, I would like to thank the Employee Experience and Internal Policy Task Force members for being a part of this process and letting us propose our ideas. So as our company has grown, our management team has become aware that we need more organizational structure. And as our mission, our team is dedicated to working towards the common good and customer trust, allowing customers to trust our decisions are the best decisions for the time being. So in order to do this, we need to implement new policies that are more structured. So I propose our company be centered around logos. I want everyone that plays a role in the company to have a reason and a logic for why they're making the decisions they're making, and then evidence to support that. Sam Leith is an English author and journalist, and he's wrote several publications, including The Wall Street Journal Europe. So he describes Aristotle's logos as what drives your argument forward, the way one point proceeds to another point, as if to show that the conclusion to which you are aiming is not only the right one, but also the only one. Specifically, our human resources functions have been handled by individual departments, which have resulted in varied experiences for employees. And this type of structure could result in ad hominem, where a single person is attacked rather than dealing with the issue at hand, since it's being handled by an individual department. And to avoid this, I want our human resources functions to be handled by the same department or decision-making team so that every employee across the organization can have a similar experience, just to kind of create more structure and consistency. And the success of this human resources change can be the substantive warrant between the same department handling the functions of human resources and the employees having a more similar experience. In addition, I want there to be a claim of policy in place that is decided by the management leaders and the CEO so the right course of action can be taken. Carmine Gallo is a business communication expert and author of a book called Talks Like TED. And in chapter 17 of Speak Up, a book that he wrote, he states that a policy claim advocates that action should be taken by organizations, institutions, or members of your audience. I want the employees of the company, particularly the leaders, to have the audience or the consumers in mind when they're proposing an idea, giving feedback, or giving their opinion, and how they could possibly react. In chapter 17 of Speak Up, also, Gallo states, he shares a story about a young girl who is communicating with a group of people and she fails to consider the reactions of the audience and how the members might respond to her plan. And overall, she believes that she's failed, and I do not want anyone in the company to make this frustrating error internally. No one deserves to feel like that. I can also foresee logical fallacies showing up in our discussions, such as a false dilemma. For example, during a discussion, a stakeholder could say, "Oh, we can implement this new idea, or we can let the company fail," as if there was no other option. And I don't like that kind of persuasion. It's not healthy. I want the company to avoid logical fallacies because they're based on unsound arguments and therefore invalid. Next, our new policy will give each employee or person that's part of the company somewhat a chance to give feedback or state their opinion on the subject at hand, but they must present to the whole company with enthusiasm, eye contact, and confidence. Chris Anderson is the head CEO, or is the head, of TED, and he wrote a chapter on mental prep and controlling nerves in communicating. And in that article, he states, if you're going to be standing on a stage addressing an audience, it means someone somewhere decided you had something of import to impart to others. So I know personally I struggle with anxiety, especially with public speaking. It's very situational, but reading that chapter, that line stood out to me, just as a kind of new key focus to think about when I'm public speaking. So probably me, along with others, just having to be required to present to the company, as uncomfortable as it is, the repetition will just help everyone become more comfortable, and it will help communication apprehension, especially my own, as I continue to share. So one concept I now plan to focus on when communicating is focusing on the opportunity and the importance of sharing my message with the audience. I will encourage this to my coworkers too, as well as just rehearsing more. But overall, I believe the company will run more smoothly with more structured policies, and just more control, more organization, consistency, maturity. And with these structured policies, we will be able to handle any obstacles thrown at us, overcome any hesitations that the organization may face.